Good morning, and thank you for keeping us company. Again, this is Why in the Morning, Y254 TV. We are talking about mental wellness this morning. We are fighting COVID-19, and so many people have been affected in one way or the other. You could be the one, or it could be your family member. How do you help them maneuver this COVID-19 pandemic healthy-wise, and of course, even help supporting them in one way or the other? I'm speaking to Anastasia Kihaga. She's a psychologist. She'll help us to put things into perspective of how you can tell someone is suffering from maybe depression or stress, or how can you help them. Send us your comments or questions to all our social media platforms, Y254 channel on Facebook and Instagram at Y254, Twitter at Morani Hillary is my handle. Good morning and welcome to the program. My name is Dereva Hillary. Good morning.
Morning to you.
Happy to have you here.
Happy to have you too.
I want to begin by asking you, yes, how is COVID-19 taking on you?
Mm-hmm.
How have you been?
I must say that COVID-19 is a tall order. Mm-hmm. I think for everyone, we are equally affected differently. Mm-hmm. One, it's because it's something that was not expected. I never expected that I could be, it could have been like this.
Right.
Unfortunately, that is where it has taken us. Mm-hmm. And therefore, I am equally affected. Having been working in institution, mm-hmm, having been going for a talk show and going for trainings, it has affected me.
Right.
But now we are resolving to go into virtual, mm-hmm, online counseling, mm-hmm, and many other things. I mean, we now need to embrace what is there,
true,
like online, mm-hmm, and virtual counseling,
true,
and virtual training,
mm-hmm,
whereby we need to restructure and to reschedule ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
So that is where I am at. Upon the imenifikisha.
COVID-19 imetupeleka places as tukuwaijua.
Yes.
But of course, I'm sure there are people who are benefiting, especially the platforms that we are using, the Zoom, the Google. They are benefiting,
yes,
from this, and who could tell?
Mm.
We could change.
Yes.
Of course, we are now living at the times where,
mm,
we are living by the words of the C.S. Motaika. We are living,
yes,
abnormally.
Yes,
the normal,
yes,
condition.
Now, if we treat it normally, it will treat it
exactly
as abnormally.
And you'll never know when it will strike.
Very
now,
true.
Speaking of striking,
mm-hmm,
we have for a long time seen mad people in the streets,
uh-huh,
collecting litters, other,
yeah,
people who have lost their minds.
Sure.
And we see how awana kilipoa.
Mm-hmm.
So we only think, majority of the people, if not all, think mental wellness,
mm-hmm,
comes as a result of maybe an abuse or something else,
mm,
of the drugs. But what is mental health per se?
Yes, I would say mental health, it is a state of mind, number one.
Mm-hmm.
And the state of mind, it's how we think,
mm-hmm,
act, and talk.
Right.
It depends on how the mind. The mind is itself is like a house,
mm-hmm,
and it affects our thinking, it affects how we talk, and it affects how we act. So what we think,
mm-hmm,
then we after thinking, then you talk about it,
mm-hmm,
and then you act it.
Right.
It starts small, whereby you need to understand if you're able to relate with other people psychologically, you're okay.
Mm-hmm.
Mentally, you're okay. Socially, you're okay. Especially mental health,
mm-hmm,
affects our psychological well-being.
Mm-hmm.
It affects our mental well-being. It also affects our social well-being. Because if my mind is not okay, I have a problem with my mind, I'm not able to relate well with people. So it will affect my social life,
sure,
the social interactions and relationship.
Mm-hmm.
It will also affect my emotional well-being. You know, human beings are emotional.
Mm-hmm.
We are emotional.
True,
that
true.
Is why we feel. And everybody feels good sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you feel sad.
Right.
Sometimes you have a feeling of, you know, you're overwhelmed, especially at this time.
Mm-hmm.
People are overwhelmed, including yourself.
Mm-hmm.
There are those moments.
True.
That doesn't mean that you are mentally ill.
Mm-hmm.
But you're just emotionally unwell.
Right.
And therefore, mental health and awareness, we need to create awareness whereby we need to understand when we are not okay.
True.
And I want to say at this point, it is okay not to be okay.
Yeah.
We are human.
Mm-hmm.
Because we have been raised and cultured in a way that genders, we should not share our issues like men. Mm-hmm. It should be very strong for others. Mm-hmm. Or even women, you're a single mother, or you're the one like the breadwinner in that family. Mm-hmm. There are those people who are like the ones, the pillars of the family, mm-hmm. and everybody wants you to be okay. And sometimes you get overwhelmed and you're not okay. Mm-hmm. You're not psychologically okay. Mentally, you're not, you emotionally, you're not okay. You feel overwhelmed.
True.
And at that point, that is a point whereby you need to seek for help. Because the more you advance it, the more you keep on keeping it, and you wait for things to happen, mm-hmm. sooner or later, you'll find yourself in the street.
Brings me to the question.
Yes.
When can I tell I have fallen to depression? Because
yes.
I will wake up in the morning, do my stuff, do everything that I do on a daily basis.
Yes.
But then you will find at some point, mm-hmm. I am broken. How can one tell I have a problem?
You need to tell you have a problem. Mm-hmm. If like now, it's okay to get angry. Mm-hmm. It's okay to like now sometimes feel you are out, you don't want to talk mm-hmm. once in a while. But if this one becomes persistent, that you don't want to talk to people, mm-hmm. you are withdrawn, mm-hmm. you feel the sense of isolation, you feel like you don't want to share your issues with people. There are those moments whereby if it's anger, it's a prolonged anger. Mm-hmm. If it's of being overwhelmed by issues, it gets prolonged. Sometimes you get yourself shouting, mm-hmm. you shout, and then it is a prolonged thing. It's a persistent thing. You look at yourself like for a week, mm-hmm. a month, and another month, and you're still behaving the same. Mm-hmm. You're still angry. You're still emotionally down. That is a point whereby that you're going down.
Right.
You need to be aware when you're not okay.
Mm-hmm.
Like when you're going down emotionally, you need to look at yourself. Like that's sometimes, okay, I know that like this time, because maybe lack of money,
right?
Lack of, okay, there are so many things that are happening in people's mind. Mm-hmm. And by the way, mental health affects adults, mm-hmm. affects teenagers, and affects children
True.
Differently.
Mm-hmm.
So when you find yourself projecting your anger persistently,
mm-hmm.
when you find yourself always emotionally down, you know, something very small triggers your anger,
mm-hmm.
something very small triggers your pain, something very small. There are people who get angry, there are people who cry,
right.
The people react differently to emotions. Mm-hmm. If you find yourself being persistent on those, or sometimes getting itchy on issues,
mm-hmm.
you're not able to solve issues because you're emotionally destabilized. You're on turbulence all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You need to check your mental wellness.
True.
Because at that moment, it is whereby you find yourself, you're going down. You know, emotionally you're going down,
mm-hmm.
psychologically you're going down, socially you lose people, and you may find that you either you're not able to resolve or to solve your own issues, mm-hmm. and you're not even ready to seek for help. Why? Because you have resolved to withdraw,
mm-hmm.
you have resolved to isolation, you have resolved to, like, it is my problem.
Mm-hmm.
When you take it as yourself, you find that now you start going down.
Mm-hmm.
And that is a time you need, that's a red flag.
I'm sensing that could be
mm-hmm.
a problem closely to the introverts, because
yes.
you say, this is me, I don't like sharing.
Mm-hmm.
But now this is the person who has come to that point, they don't want to share, they have withdrawn from people, and they think, now this is the new me, maybe I have discovered myself.
Yes.
They do not know that's a problem.
Mm-hmm.
Now that you have mentioned, could be the symptoms, we could call it the symptoms of the depression, where someone has withdrawn from people and they think this is the new normal.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for someone who is living with such a person,
mm-hmm.
how can I tell that this person has a problem and they need help?
As you have said, personality equally comes into play.
Mm-hmm.
The extrovert may behave overly, you know, you see people behaving out, you know, those
mm-hmm.
issues, you find themselves, it's like they are throwing tantrums, they are all over.
Right.
But the introverts, they may choose to resolve.
Mm-hmm.
If you find yourself in such a manner, whereby some of the symptoms of depression,
mm-hmm.
it's one of it is withdrawal. Withdrawal is quite, it's quite often,
mm-hmm.
then you get isolated, then you get something we call sleepless nights, insomnia.
Mm-hmm.
You could also be down in terms of your urges.
Mm-hmm.
If you're a married couple, your sexual urges may go down.
Mm-hmm.
On the other hand, you don't even want to work, you don't want to be with people,
mm-hmm.
you're like on your own. And that is a time you'll find those signs start coming out. Or you're always angry, you know, that anger that is not getting, it's not dissolving. Mm-hmm. Or that pain, you feel, sometimes you get even pains all over, mm-hmm. somatic mm-hmm. pains. We call it hapa-hapa mm-hmm. syndrome, whereby you get somatic pains, you don't know where it's paining. Mm-hmm. You may also get headaches. Mm-hmm. That is a sign that things are not okay, especially those persistent, the persistent one, that you used to sleep okay, mm-hmm. but now you cannot sleep. Mm-hmm. We call it insomnia. Mm-hmm. You need to check your cycles. Mm-hmm. And that way, you're able to notice, am I okay? And if I'm not okay, that is a point we need to create awareness. People are not okay, but mm-hmm. they're not ready to share.
True.
You die with your problems.
Mm-hmm.
You're not working. You used to work, and now the new normal.
Mm-hmm.
It's easier said than done. Mm-hmm. Adapting to new normal, it's not easy because you need to pay house rent. You need to take care of your children. You need to take care of your bills. Nobody's going to samehea you because mm-hmm. you haven't paid your bill.
Mm-hmm.
So the bills are going to come. So who is going to foot them? Remember,
mm-hmm.
so that is a point you need to ask yourself: what do I need to do?
Mm-hmm.
Who do I need to talk to?
Mm-hmm.
And most of the time, it may happen that people may go to resolve. They may get comfort from other things like alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
They may plug to alcohol. Other people go to drug and substance abuse. You know, when I take one, when I'm high on something, I tend to forget things.
True.
Or when I enter into sexual addiction, many things. Or they enter into pornography. The young people, mm-hmm. when they are stressed, like this time, they're in the houses.
Freedom.
A lot of stress. You know, that prolonged stress,
mm-hmm.
it may end up taking you to depression. Because if you have the prolonged stress for some time and then it's not getting resolved, you have issues that have not been, you know, the pending issues, you're not dealing with an issue. Today, I have something to deal with.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow, I have something to deal with. I haven't dealt with the first one. The second one has come and the third one.
Mm-hmm.
Those pile up, the pile up, it may break you down.
True.
So the best thing is communicate your issue mm-hmm. early enough.
Mm-hmm.
And then solve a problem as it comes. Unfortunately, that is not the way it happens, according to the new normal.
Yeah, actually, mm-hmm. the new normal, we are living at a time where we are speaking of the haters, fake friends.
Yes.
I will tell you my problems and then you broadcast me.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So how now do I start sharing? Who do I share with? And especially like such a time, we're speaking of COVID-19, people
mm-hmm.
have been laid off,
mm-hmm.
the pay cuts.
Mm-hmm.
I can't afford a counselor.
Yes.
Is there a way, is there a mechanism I can solve my problems within my confines without
yes.
having to tell anyone?
Mm-hmm.
Because if I tell someone, they will broadcast me.
Number one, the best place to solve your issues,
mm-hmm.
it's from a family setup. And that is where we need the family support,
mm-hmm.
the psychosocial support. We
right.
started from the family, at family level. If you're living with family, you're either an adult, you're a man,
mm-hmm.
or a woman, you're a wife to someone, or a husband to someone, please share with your husband. That is when we need a dialogue. This is a time we need a lot of communication,
mm-hmm.
because we are socially distant.
Mm-hmm.
So even if I want to walk and go talk to somebody, maybe it's not possible. Let's make use of the family setup.
Mm-hmm.
If you're a child, you're a teenager, please talk to your mom about your concern. If you're stressed, if something is not working on well,
mm-hmm.
you know, these are the times that parents are shouting because the children are eating a lot of food
mm-hmm.
and the food is not adding itself. You know,
mm-hmm.
you find those moments whereby the food is not multiplying, but the eaters are multiplying every day. The
mm-hmm.
stomach is widening every day.
Mm-hmm.
So those are the moments you need to tell your mom
mm-hmm.
or your dad, please, mom, you're shouting to me quite much. You
mm-hmm.
need to
mm-hmm.
understand that I'm equally not getting along with it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not feeling well when you shout at me.
Mm-hmm.
But when you don't talk about it, it will again escalate. And after it escalates,
mm-hmm.
the teenager or the child is going to get stressed. So at family level, let's solve our issues at family level. That is why we need to have a loud table with the family.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, if you can reach out to somebody, maybe for those who are living single, maybe you're single
mm-hmm.
and you're living alone, you need to, we have phone calls, get your friends, we have circles of friends. We have the people who are in the inner circle and the outer circle. Mm-hmm. We need to get to make use of the inner circles, whereby I have somebody that I can reach. Do I have someone? Everybody must be having someone. Mm-hmm. And you need to know your friends at this time, especially when you're in need. That mm-hmm. is when you know your friends. Is there somebody that that is phone call away? And I call them. If it means video calling or Zooming, whatever, let's make use of the online platforms mm-hmm. that can communicate our needs. Mm-hmm. Like I found in the Facebook whereby people communicate. I have seen somebody, a young person writing, please, if in case I am not there anymore, mm-hmm. just know that I have already, you know, they create those signs, the red flags that somebody wants to commit suicide.
Right.
And that is one of the symptoms that somebody is depressed. Mm-hmm. If you hear them talking of committing suicide or they're looking for an exit plan, before you get there, please look for somebody, either your parents, mm-hmm. if you're able, mm-hmm. or your friend, if you're able, please look for an outlet to vent out your anger. Because sometimes people are stressed because I have not gotten anybody. Mm-hmm. I have not gotten anybody to vent out my anger,
right?
And it gets, I inhibit it, mm-hmm. and the more I inhibit it, the more I am building a time bomb, mm-hmm. and sooner or later it's gonna explode.
Right.
You can imagine what we have found out of COVID-19. People have killed themselves.
True.
People have killed their loved one. You remember that woman who killed her four children? Mm. That is something that was working out. It's because she never got anybody, a support system. We need to develop support system. Mm-hmm. It's good for somebody to litter. Can I get somebody to litter out too? Mm-hmm. Can I talk to somebody at any time? Mm-hmm. You know, those are the, as you have said, we have gotten to a point whereby people mm-hmm. are betraying us.
True.
And because we have been betrayed in the past, mm-hmm. you fear.
True.
And that is because of the trust issues. They are quite much at this time, because if I can't trust you with a small bit, mm-hmm. let's be a custodian of our own friends. Let's be a custodian of our own mates. Mm-hmm. Let's be a custodian of our friends. Can I become a bank? That is what in my psychological field, mm-hmm. I've always asked myself, can I become a bank that somebody can invest in me mm-hmm. without giving a PIN number?
Oh,
that is a psychologist.
Okay.
I should be a bank mm-hmm. that somebody is investing their pain in me. Oh, of course, I have a way of venting it out. We have supervision. Mm-hmm. So can somebody invest in me their pain, mm-hmm. their anger, and I will not again mm-hmm. open that. I will not be an opening again mm-hmm. to go and start spreading the same pain to others. So can I have a pin whereby that somebody can communicate with me mm-hmm. and I'm able to keep the secret.
Yeah.
Not as, of course we don't keep the secret when somebody wants to commit suicide.
Yeah.
You have to share with the support system.
Mm-hmm.
But then I need to be that somebody. Can I listen to you, Hilary? Mm-hmm. And then after listening to you, mm-hmm. how will I react or respond to your issues?
Mm-hmm.
So you need to look for such a person. And I'm sure at this time of COVID-19, this is a time, I'm not sure that, you know, there are people who are saying there is COVID-19 and there is corona.
Yeah.
So I don't know, whichever you
whichever
you want. Mm. So at this time, you need to ask yourself, who are my circles? Who are in my circles? There are circles of five, the closer one.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you don't even have, at least you should have one. Even
one.
Me, I have one friend mm. that I share with. You know, we talk mm-hmm. and we are very close.
Mm-hmm.
And after talking, I feel a relief. Why? Because that person will not go share about me.
Yeah.
They will not talk about my family. They will not. And everybody has weakness.
Yeah,
everybody has
perfect.
Problems.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm. But the way out.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Now, we have a problem. You want to help.
Mm-hmm.
But we have a problem with this person who needs help.
Mm.
I don't know whether they want to. Someone to listen mm-hmm. or they need to be told.
Mm-hmm.
We have had a problem where mm-hmm. someone wants to vent out,
mm-hmm.
then you are there giving the advices, yet they didn't want that advice. They
yes.
just wanted someone to listen.
Mm-hmm.
Now, how do I define the terms of mm-hmm. what kind of help do this person want? Is it
mm-hmm.
listening or
mm-hmm.
is it listening and advice?
Mm-hmm.
What do you do?
I think it's the high time we understand about mental health.
Mm-hmm.
Mental health, you need to understand, it is a pain that is not seen with physical eyes. you're getting. Mm-hmm. You know, when I'm hurting, when my heart is hurting, like my heart was hurting some that last month, it was very hurting, I had a problem. Mm-hmm. And when the heart is hurting, you know, I get the attention of everyone.
Yeah.
I get the attention of my husband and my children. You know, they can see I'm hanging something.
Mm-hmm.
But the mental wellness, it's the mind. And you can imagine the same pain I'm feeling on my heart,
mm-hmm.
that is the same pain the person who is mentally unwell is feeling.
Right.
If they tell you they have a headache, please don't ignore. If they tell you they feel they haven't had sleep last night, please listen to them. If they tell you that they feel like killing themselves, please don't ignore. Don't mm-hmm. ignore those small signs.
Mm-hmm.
And remember, it may not be physical. It's not seen.
Right.
The mental wellness, it's not seen. It's not visible.
Mm-hmm.
I can smile. I have a very broad smile,
mm-hmm.
if you can realize. I can smile to people there outside.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a good smile. But that is outside.
Right.
Maybe inside, I am hurting. Inside, I am crying from inside.
Mm-hmm.
I am feeling the pain inside, but it's not seen outside. And that is the point whereby we need to create that awareness, that mental wellness,
mm-hmm.
it is whereby you need to understand that somebody is hurting from inside. It is easier to have a physical beating,
right.
whereby you do the violent people, they will beat you physically. But there are people who will beat you emotionally.
Mm-hmm. With words.
There are people who will attack you emotionally.
Mm-hmm.
They attack your ego. They attack your physique.
Mm-hmm.
And they attack even what you're doing. And somebody anakwambia kijambo, hila limbaka unasema, what?
Ameniua.
Yes, you kill somebody with your words.
Mm-hmm.
And at this point, as you're saying, you need to mind your words.
Mm-hmm.
What words do you speak to somebody? And as you've said, there are people who will come to you. They
mm-hmm.
just want a hearing ear.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the skills that we have in counseling, it's an active listening.
Yeah.
Sometimes just I have talked to somebody on the phone and they will talk to me 2 hours without responding, just
right.
listening to them, especially the suicidal people.
Mm-hmm.
It is good to hear from the point of view. And from the point of view of the other person, the person who is talking to you,
mm-hmm.
in counseling, we don't advise. We explore issues. You explore the possible outcome.
Mm-hmm.
You explore the possible solution. Because if somebody tells me they don't have money for house rent,
mm-hmm.
I don't have a solution. So we'll explore the possible outcome because I don't have rent to pay for them.
Mm-hmm.
But of course, I will help that person to see the issue in a different way.
Right.
Yes. You mm-hmm. see, it's a mindset issue.
Mm-hmm.
This one is the mental health. It's about the mind.
Mm-hmm.
You restructure the mind of somebody.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody tells you that they want to commit suicide, you just do the restructuring of the mind whereby you tell them, let's explore option. Because when somebody wants to commit suicide, that is an exit plan.
Mm-hmm.
They have already said, I have explored other options, and the only exit plan
mm-hmm. it
is to have myself. This is the only escape route. I want to die.
Mm-hmm.
And what used to use the yes, the faster and the less painful.
Mm-hmm.
But remember, that person is under mental torture. So what do you need to address? You need to address their minds. You need to address their mind. The problem is their thought life has a problem because they have thought aloud themselves. And they have concluded that the only way that I want to exit, my exit plan is dying. So you check on their thought line by listening to them. You can only get the thought line of a person. Somebody told me that they fear me. Another guy told me that he fears me because he's fearing that I'm able to read his mind. And I told him I don't. Sometimes I don't have to be leading somebody's mind. But by the way somebody is talking, you need to listen to somebody's storyline,
right.
not mine. It's not me who has an issue.
Yeah.
So I need to listen to somebody's storyline. After listening to the storyline, please add the dots. And sometimes the people who are mentally sick, the storyline doesn't add up. You'll get the incongruency. There is that breakup.
Right.
Somebody will tell you, this is what is happening. Mm-hmm. After sometimes, okay, you tell them, okay, I can hear you. And then after you tell them like that, the story changes. When there is that incongruence of the story, you need to now stop and tell them. You said we use something we call rephrasing.
Mm-hmm.
You put back the question to them.
Yeah,
don't use your own words.
Mm-hmm.
Use the same words. And that's a mechanic.
Right.
And then on the other hand, there is another technique. If you're in a conflict with somebody, sit down with them the way we are seated with you, look at them in their eyes. That's also a communication. And by the way, silence, it's the best answer sometimes you can give to somebody. It is an answer on itself. You see the way you keep quiet and you don't even answer to issues, because sometimes answering, it can either be reactive as opposed to responding to an issue. So sometimes just keep quiet. We are living in times whereby people are stressed because of loss. You can imagine people have lost their loved one. And you expect them to be okay. No, they are not okay. One, because the mourning period is very short. After somebody dies these days, they are buried within a very short time. And you're not giving people an opportunity to mourn. You're again building another problem. We'll get anxiety disorders, we'll get, and it can even be psychotic, whereby people will even become, it even become post-traumatic disorder. Because people were not given an opportunity to mourn. Mental health has been stigmatized, whereby it's like when somebody tells you that I am not okay, it's like I'm seeking for an attention. I'm here to let us know that when somebody tells you that they are not okay, please listen to them. They are not seeking for attention. And when somebody is crying, if somebody comes to you, please be a shoulder to lean on. Because sometimes we cut the conversation by telling somebody, please stop. Goja kwanza. Please stop crying. Talk to me. Let them cry, because even cry speaks. And sometimes there are people, I told you, there are people who vent out through crying. There are people who don't shout and throw tantrums because they are able to reserve their emotional turbulences. But there are people who will cry. There are people who will shout in anger. I know you've seen during a time of a loss, somebody has lost a loved one. Some will shout and some will cry. Give people an opportunity. You're there. You as a friend or somebody like a professional like me, I'm there to listen and pick the points, even in the cry. Even in the cry, pick the conversation. Pick what are they communicating in their cry. We have a lot of ignorance in our country. Honestly, I must say that we have a lot of ignorance. We are not able to listen to the emotional awareness of people. We cannot be able. You need to listen to the feeling of people.
Yeah, actually know that you're seeing of the feeling. Mm-hmm. I'm looking at these persons, maybe they're a couple, they are married, one has lost their job, or maybe something has happened in their family, maybe from the other side of the other person, and then you're there, you're trying to listen to them and you're like, how do I support my partner? Maybe they have lost their job, maybe something has happened to them, because not even COVID-19.
Yes.
We have COVID-19. We live after COVID-19.
Yes.
So how else can you support even someone who is your partner? It is someone you expect to know so much, but then you understand they have changed. How do I tell this is a mental problem, or it's just a behavior that has come up? Nisianze kukasirika pia tukosane, kumbe they were not okay. How do I tell my partner it has a problem?
One of the ways that you need to address that, you need to understand that when there is behavior change, a pattern, you know, a certain pattern has all of us changed. A certain pattern in your house has all over changed. The only way you can be able to help somebody, it is by listening to them. Number one, listening to them. Number two, communicate your issues together.
Right.
That is when we need to have a dialogue. Maybe you're going to ask me, at the point of crisis, how do you communicate? At the point whereby there are crises, how do you communicate?
Right.
That point whereby there is no communication, where there are conflicts, and the conflict is escalating. Have you ever realized that the more you make noise, the more you socially distance? Even not even talk about the social distance, the one for Mutahi, or the ones for WHO, talk about the social distances. The more, like now if you start, you see the way we are talking with you, we are doing a conversation. But the moment we have a conflict, we start shouting to one another. And the more you shout to one another, the more the hearts get distance. You know, you socially distance. That is when you hear somebody has withdrawn in terms of it's nailed by mouth. Or you get a code treatment whereby things are not working well. If it's a couple like the way you've asked, the bedroom becomes an issue. If a teen and a mother, or a teen and a father, they no longer talk. It's a nail by mouth. Why? Because of that social distances. The social distance, when you feel that you cannot communicate with your spouse, and it is okay to communicate about a loss of a job. Mm-hmm. Who cannot lose a job? We have all lost jobs. You communicate about it. And if you cannot communicate, two of you, because of the conflict, please look for a third party, somebody you can trust, mm-hmm. or a professional. Yes, somebody that you can trust or a professional. That is why we need to create awareness on the mental health, mm-hmm. a lot.
We are speaking of COVID-19.
Yes.
So the families or individuals have been affected, mm-hmm. in one way or the other.
Mm-hmm.
And especially the recoveries from mm-hmm. the COVID-19.
Mm-hmm.
These are persons or someone who was suspected to have COVID-19.
Mm-hmm.
There is stigmatization.
Mm-hmm.
Now, how do I help myself?
Mm-hmm.
Through the waves of the stigma from friends, from maybe where I live, my mm-hmm. neighbors, or even at work. How now do I come out clearly and stand strong even when people see me and brand me COVID-19?
The stigma associated with COVID-19,
mm-hmm.
it's quite much in the society.
Mm-hmm.
One, because people are not aware that I should separate the COVID-19
mm-hmm.
from the individual. You healerly,
yeah.
but I should not associate you with a sickness.
Mm-hmm.
You should not associate somebody with a sickness. Like you call somebody mad, that's wrong.
Mm-hmm.
The madness, it's an ailment.
Yeah.
You know, the psychotic, being psychotic or having a disorder, a mood disorder or an anxiety disorder,
mm-hmm.
that is an ailment. You treat somebody, you know, you pick individual, this is me,
mm-hmm.
but I need to be separated from my issues. But unfortunately, we intertwine.
Mm-hmm.
We are not able to separate the two. So we thread in the person with the issue. And we need to know that it's either in the society,
mm-hmm.
somebody is affected or infected. And we are all affected. Why? I'm communicating with you.
Right.
I don't know where I can pick the disease. Anybody can be infected. Anybody can be affected. And therefore, treat people with a lot of
mm-hmm.
Treat people with a lot of love, and also have that unconditional positive regard. Mm-hmm. Let's regard people as people. We are human. And if somebody die of COVID-19, mm-hmm. or somebody is affected with COVID-19, please mm-hmm. treat them as a human being. COVID-19 does not separate you from being who you are.
Mm-hmm.
Let's reserve the dignity of people. And therefore, as a society, let's not associate COVID-19 with the stigma, because we are causing more stress.
Mm-hmm.
We are causing more pain to people. You're causing more harm than normal.
Yeah.
And that is where you're finding people are fearing to go to the hospital to be tested.
True.
Because of the stigma.
Mm-hmm.
You can imagine, if I get cold today, if I start coughing on the streets, somebody will tell me, eh.
Yeah.
You know, it's like treating like a social outcast, even at the family level. Please mm-hmm. remind yourself that this is a sickness like any other. The way we have treated the people with the terminal illness, the cancer,
mm-hmm.
the diabetes, the hypertension, even a common cold. Let's treat the disease as a disease,
mm-hmm.
and let's not intertwine it with the human being.
Right.
Let's remember that this is a human being. The way you talk, remember the tongue, I remind us again.
Mm-hmm.
The way you talk to someone, and it can also happen to me.
Right.
So I have always asked myself, would I wish to be treated the way I treat the other person?
Mm-hmm.
Might the other person? And remember, you can also be affected or infected. So we need to work as a team.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is the best time to use the Nyumba Kumi initiative,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
whereby let's support each other as a team, as opposed to working as a person.
Mm-hmm.
Let's work as a team. I remember that when I take care of my neighbor,
mm-hmm.
I take care of myself.
True.
By doing the wearing the mask, keeping the social distance, and sanitization.
True.
So when I take care of myself and my children and my family,
mm-hmm.
remember I'm taking care of you and your family. So that is the best way, as opposed to the stigma or stigmatizing people.
Mm-hmm.
Let's observe the precautions. I remember when I observed the precautions, when I wear a mask, it is not about me alone. Mm-hmm. You know, there is that selfishness of whereby, hey, my family, we are protected, you know. But remember, we are human beings. We'll still get in touch with other people one in one way or on another. True. Okay, there are those people who are indoors, they are not moving out. But in one way or another, you'll get in touch with other people.
Someone, yeah.
So, mind about your neighbor. That is what I can say.
Exactly.
To reduce stigma, mm-hmm. let's mind about my neighbor. And when I take care of myself, mm-hmm. I've taken care of my neighbor. You can imagine if we can do that, an initiative of Nyumba Kumi, mm-hmm. and also let's have our own support system. Let's check on one another. Mm-hmm. Tell somebody that I'm here for you. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's very easy, mm-hmm. but
yeah,
sometimes
say,
I just tell somebody,
you.
I don't have anything to say, mm-hmm. but just know that you can reach out to me.
Some people say, sasa nikimwambia niko hapa and then they ask me for rent, what will I do?
Okay, one you don't have to post like a sponsor.
Mm-hmm.
Or I don't know. Or
you know, we send a wrong message when we say, I am here for you.
Yes.
Feel free.
Uh-huh.
Then someone will come telling you all their problems. And then I'm like, I realize, guy, I couldn't handle.
When you say that you're here for them,
mm-hmm.
it doesn't communicate that you're there to support them.
Right.
And always say, I will as far as I can.
Oh.
Don't commit yourself. It's a non-committal.
Mm-hmm.
Just tell somebody, please get to me.
Mm-hmm.
I will support you as far as I can.
Right.
Don't forget that statement.
Mm-hmm.
Because you cannot act like somebody's husband. You cannot act as somebody's wife.
Mm-hmm.
But you can act as a friend. As far as the boundaries, remember, you also need to maintain your boundaries.
Mm-hmm.
You need to keep your boundaries and say, I can only be able to assist you by maybe giving you mm-hmm. my support in terms of listening here,
mm-hmm.
in terms of having a call away, just listening to you, but I may not be able to pay for you rent. Because mm-hmm. people, by the way you're saying, people extend help even to the bedroom. And it brings another issue.
True.
So do as far as you can.
Mm-hmm.
You're not Jesus. You're not the savior of this world. If it's only Jesus who died for us, you cannot save the world again.
Humans.
Yes, we are limited.
Yeah.
So maintain those limitations. Even with I think the social distance is working on well because we are able to retain the limits.
The limits.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, as we conclude, mm-hmm. there has been I think the president. Directed that a report should be prepared for the mental wellness, and it has been a debate even in the parliament.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think at this point mental wellness awareness has been created enough,
mm-hmm.
and do you think we're having the support maybe even from the government and the stakeholders?
Mm-hmm. I must say, even from this platform,
mm-hmm.
that we need to invest as a government,
mm-hmm.
we need to invest in mental health. Because most of the issues can be solved from a very minimal level that will not even hurt the country economically. If we are able, like now in the time of COVID-19, mm-hmm. people are infected with fear. And there are people who are getting more stressed mm-hmm. or more, the ailment is escalating because of the fear of COVID-19.
Mm-hmm.
There are people who are killing themselves. You know, you can imagine the aftermath. We need to take care of the aftermath of COVID-19
mm-hmm.
and understand that if we are able to take care of mental health and wellness, we'll not escalate problems.
Mm-hmm.
Like now we have teens pregnancy.
True.
We need to invest in our school program.
Mm-hmm.
Even at now, as at now that people are outside, they are in the houses, our children are in the houses. As the government put in structures to take care of mental health and wellness, we need to understand that already there is a stigma that is associated with our mm-hmm. academic system because the children are not in school.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever is happening outside there, they are getting into drugs, mm-hmm. they're getting into pornography, they're getting into teens pregnancies. And there are people who have been laid off from the place of work,
mm-hmm.
they are getting into depression. And sooner or later, we'll have so many people who are committing suicide or they are homicide or they will kill others.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, as a government, my take is we need to create more awareness about mental health,
mm-hmm.
mental health,
mm-hmm.
because it is very key. If you're able to solve the mind, if you're able to resolve the problem from the mind, the setup of mind of somebody and invest in the mindset of somebody, we are able to solve many problems. Even the workplace, if you're productive, if like now you come here when you're stressed, you're counterproductive, you'll not be able to be productive as usual. Even in the hospitals, our nurses, our healthcare providers, if they're not mentally well, remember we are also failing them,
and they are also
at the face of the risk, and therefore they are stressed. But remember, that person is stressed at night and they're going to wake up again, go for another shift the following morning. But who takes care of their mental wellness? Whom do they vent out to? Do they have a deep briefing? Do they have somebody who listens to them? Because sometimes, you know, mental health can be seen. I've said it's not seen.
Yeah, true.
And you can imagine somebody who is depressed and they're the ones taking care of the sick person.
That's somebody who's have mistakes.
Yes, we make mess. There is more mess than good that is happening in our nation. You find the people in the media, even the media personalities, they are at the front line taking for us the news. But after that, after seeing that they are equally at risk of getting the disease, they're equally at risk of getting infected. But after that, after taking the news, you know, the social icon, the social media platform, the people in the front line, even the politicians themselves, even the members of parliament themselves, everybody is at risk. But after that, who takes care of having somebody to debrief from the problem that they have? Do they have somebody who sits with them down and tell them, oh, we are sorry?
Yeah.
And just know that we are here for you. We know what you're doing at the prison work, you can imagine. Nobody is bothering. So we need to invest more in the mental health. I still feel in our country, Kenya, we have still not yet given mental health a priority.
Yeah.
I support that we need to give mental health a priority. We need to give it a priority from a family level, from an institution level in our schools, especially our schools.
Okay.
When I look at what is happening in our nation, especially the next generation now, they are into drugs, they're out of school. Some of them, they have already given up on their studies. Because if somebody was in Form 4, somebody was in Class 8, unless they get somebody to encourage them that they will pick up from where they stopped, we are going to have issues.
Many
dropouts, and people have already said it's okay, even this academic, we can do away with it. Done away with it. So
there are no jobs.
There are no jobs. They have decided to do away with it. So let the government put things in structures.
Yeah.
We need counselors in schools because after reopening, okay, we'll take the measures, the precautions. We'll take the measures and put things in order. We'll put the sanitizers, we'll put the mask, and we'll put the social distances even as we prepare to get back to normalcy, which is the new normal. But remember, we have not taken care of the stigma associated with COVID-19. We have not taken care of the stresses. We have not taken care of the post-trauma. Remember, this something, COVID-19 is an event that was not expected by anybody. And therefore, people are traumatized. Everybody is traumatized. It's only that some of us have shock absorbers, but people are traumatized.
True.
So there are people who are going to suffer post-traumatic stress disorders. How will we cover that? There are people who have lost their loved one. They are grieving from their social distance. They're socially distant from others, and they are grieving. Those are the same people that will take to the place of work.
Right.
So you can imagine. So I encourage the corporate, I encourage the government, and everybody to embrace mental health. And I repeat this again, even as we wind up. Mental health is not an ailment. It's not an illness that is physically feasible, but it's an illness that affects and pains somebody. But in the mind.
All right. Now, finally, we have seen the problem that comes around with along with the mental wellness. How do I keep myself sane? How do I protect myself? How do I keep myself from falling into depression, maybe stress? How do I handle, like you mentioned, how do I handle that problem as it comes?
Yes.
That I may not even fall into depression, or maybe being at a point where now I am lost.
One, you need to be aware. Aware of to what extent can I stress myself. You need to have that self-awareness. Self-awareness whereby you need to understand, at what point do I feel stressed? At what point do I get angry? What are my triggers? Mm-hmm. There are people, because of their past experiences, because of their family past experiences, mm-hmm. because of their childhood experiences, mm-hmm. they get triggers. Mm-hmm. They get triggers. And once they get the triggers, mm-hmm. it escalates the pain. Mm-hmm. So you need to understand, what are my triggers? When am I stretched, overstretched? Even at the place of work, mm-hmm. when am I overstretched that I cannot take in anymore? When is a point whereby, what is it that is affecting me, mm-hmm. that I'm getting sleepless nights? Mm-hmm. What is it that is affecting me that I was not drinking and now have started another behavior of alcoholism or drug and substance abuse? Mm-hmm. What is it that I was not doing? You need to check the behavior change. And if the behavior change, it's going on the opposite direction, mm-hmm. that is a point you need to sit down with yourself, mm-hmm. and do a personal reflection. Right. If you find that you cannot be able to support yourself, mm-hmm. please seek professional help. That is why we have professional help.
Okay.
And we have the professionals, mm-hmm. to take care of you,
right.
even at the place of work.
Mm.
Yes.
Now,
so we need to advocate for that. That
true.
Even you people, after you do the after you air the show, mm-hmm. you need to do a deep
need someone to check on us.
Yes.
All right. Now, this is your camera.
Yes.
Your final recommendations and what you'd want the youth to know, especially now that they are free home, they are staying at home, they have nothing to do. Mm-hmm. The teenagers, we have seen how they are exploring things.
Yes.
And we don't want to get to a situation that we cannot handle later.
Yes. I am Anastasia Kehwaga. I'm a counselor psychologist and I'm resting the youth. I want to talk to you and tell you that we love you and we care for you. And COVID-19 has affected everyone, and everyone is equally stressed or distressed. And therefore, I want to remind us, young people, please do not bury your dream. Remember, you still have a vision. And if at one point you felt like things are at a stop, and you felt like your life has come to a stop, I want to remind you that academic progress will still be on. You're never delay, it's only a delay, but the education sector is going to pick up from where you left. There is nothing that is going to stop, and therefore, please take care of yourself. Remember, whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you drink, and whatever you do, you need to mind about your thoughts, you need to mind about your actions, and you need to mind about your behavior, because whatever you're going to do now, it is going to affect your today and your future. So we are seeing you at the future. You're a bright people, and we expect you to be. You're the one who is going to take after us. So please remember, don't give up and do not test. You're not a test tube. Please don't be curious to do a testing. Don't test with your neighbor. If you're a girl, don't test with another girl. I will remind us, the young people, remember that We are social being, I understand, but mind the peer influence. Don't get influence. I am not saying that you should not have friends, but I'm saying mind the peer influence. And always stand. Let your no be no and your yes be yes. We need you to be assertive. Let your no be no and let your yes be yes. And don't lose focus. Please, even as you stay in your houses, remind yourself that you need to check on the books, because you still pick up from where you left. Please check on the books and also be morally upright. If you can join a social club in the Facebook or somewhere, and also remember, you need to build up your faith. You need to build up your faith to be morally upright. So it is good to check on those things. I thank you, because you're better tomorrow than today. So take care. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much, Anastasia, for coming and sharing your experience in this particular field and helping our young people out there. I believe they have learned something. And what we've gathered from here, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. You can kill someone or you can build someone. And of course, the bank you've mentioned. Can you be a bank that don't share the PIN? to see Sambazane. If someone shares with you, please keep it to yourself. They needed help. They didn't need someone else. If they wanted someone to know their story, they could have published it.
They could have broadcasted.
But now they told you because they trusted you.
Yes.
Thank you so much. That marks the end of this segment. I thank you for keeping us company. She has been my guest, Anastasia Kahaga. She's a psychologist. I'll be seeing you again in a few minutes with Politics Now. My name is Dereva Hilary. Good morning.
Thank you.